I'm going on a quick side quest in my project to build an MMU unit for my V2.4. The MMU is going to need a runout switch very close to the inlet of the extruder. And as I thought about modifying my system to incorporate that, I really took a second thought about the performance of my printer. I've been running a stealth burner. I love the stealth burner. I think it's an iconic part of the Voron aesthetic, but I'm running a UHF hot end, which requires a modified version of the stealth burner with lengthened part cooling fan ducts to accommodate the extra length of the UHF melt zone. Part cooling has always been a little bit of a problem, so I figured if I was going to go ahead and change things up to add in the runout sensor that I needed, maybe it was time to consider a new tool head. And the tool head that I'm going to build is the Reaper. The Reaper is currently in beta testing, but it has a large number of people that are using it. It accommodates 3 different probe types, 16 different hot ends, several variations of extruders. There are even different options for what aesthetic you like. There's good documentation for it. There's a configurator where you can select the options that you want, and you can download a zip file that has all the STLs. Where there are some options that are kind of unique to the Voron, which is the tap carriage mounts, the Reaper does also have its own carriage design that will work on either MGN9 or MGN12 carriages, accommodating either 6 or 9 millimeter belts. I've started my build, and here's what I've got so far. This is the tool head that I'm building. It has the dual 5015 Vendor part cooling fans. There's one of our new 3010 axial fans for hot end cooling, which is a 3-wire fan that incorporates a tack line. So I can run that into the control board and get monitoring that will let me know if there's any problems with the hot end fan. I'm using a Dragon UHF hot end in this with a 100-watt heating element from Luke's laboratory. I'm going to be using the Wristwatch G2 extruder, just like I put on my Micron, but I am using a modified version that incorporates 2 filament runout switches, one above the extruder and one below. So that should give me all the feedback that I need for the MMU. So at this point, I'm waiting for a couple of parts to come in so that I can complete the extruder and then button all this up. Once that's done, I have to install and wire the LEDs and then get everything wired back to my toolhead board. I'm going to do a follow-up to this video showing you how to assemble the Reaper toolhead as well as installation on the 2.4. So stay tuned for that, and we'll take a look at what the Reaper will do.